Hey YouTube, Zach Claudius here. Welcome to another video. Welcome to those of you tuning in for the first time. You know, in Europe now, and especially here in America, the things that we do basically have to be measured against Muslim sensibilities. Of course, that happens more or less more in Europe than here, but it's starting to become more prevalent here. And quite frankly, I am beginning to despise it. But the issue here is a German soccer team in Europe basically made a song, a fight song. I guess it's their, every club has one. But basically, they made a fight song, and in a nutshell, it references the prophet of Islam, Muhammad, and it makes a comparison that basically he doesn't know anything about football, but that he'll choose the colors of the football team, white and blue. And as usual, Muslim sensibilities were offended yet again over absolutely nothing. Because all they're doing is just basically, it's just a song. And there were email protests and basically phone calls protesting that the German team did this. And my thing is this. If Muslims, and let me be clear here, not all Muslims, but if those Muslims that were offended by this, If they're offended by it, then they should be offended by the fact that their very Qur'an basically says all these things about Jews, Christians, and non-Muslims, but people who are like Hindus, Buddhists. I mean, let's face it, the Qur'an contains hate speech. It says it itself, do not take Jews and Christians as friends. I mean, it advocates jihad in the name of God and Muhammad and to advance Allah's cause and his religion. I mean, it says all these things, but yet there are those Muslims out there that are ignorant to these facts. And yet, when you look at the evidence of what's happening around the world with what's happening in Nigeria, where the federal government of Nigeria had to send troops in the north to stop, basically, the Islamists from wreaking havoc. The issues of what's happening in Pakistan and Afghanistan. The issues of what's happening in Iran. I mean, it's clearly obvious that Islam is the catalyst in all these problems. Likewise, Islam is the catalyst in the issues of the Middle East, in the issues of Palestine and Israel. Again, the problem with Israel is not because the Israelis took land from the Palestinians, but it's the fact that they're Jews. Even if Israel didn't exist, Islam would still hate the Jews. They've said it themselves so many times. I mean, it doesn't take a scholar to figure this out. Just go on YouTube or on the internet and you'll see for yourself all the hate speech by these imams and so-called scholars. And they keep telling us time after time that Islam is a religion of tolerance. Islam is a religion of peace. But when you look at the evidence, it's a religion of war, violence, sexism, and basically the degradation of simple and the most basic human rights. If these Muslims that are offended by this song, if they're offended by this song that the German team basically did, then they should remove, and I repeat again, they should remove all the hate verses from the Quran. And the problem is that they can't. because to do so would mean it would change the very nature of Islam itself. And to do that would mean that Islam would not be Islam no more. It would be some bastardized version that basically contains verses that are peaceful rather than hate mongering. Don't get me wrong, the Quran does contain peaceful verses, but we cannot ignore also that it has hate verses as well. Anyways, that's my spiel for now. I look forward to any comments. I look forward to any feedback. And keep in mind, this is just an opinion. I do think that Muslims do take things a bit too far. They don't understand what freedom of thought, religion, satire, and all these things that we in the West basically take for granted. And I don't want to say take for granted because I think that's a bad phrase, but a right that we enjoy, and we enjoy it very faithfully because we had to fight for it long ago. And we've had to fight for it many other times to basically preserve that basic human right. But the problem is that Islam has no basic human rights. The only rights there are of men. Not the rights of women or minorities, but the rights of men, Muslim men. Anyways, shut up.